nice cruise, it was time for our descent into Cape Town. So after covering Lyft since its inception, did Lyft actually live up to its reputation? Of course, not by the Kalula.com founder and the Uber SA top executive, Lyft was bound for success. But let's see if the experience really was as good as how it seemed to other people.
As we make our arrival into Johannesburg, please remember to like and subscribe to the Aviators South Africa YouTube channel. Follow them on Instagram at @_aviators_SA prior to disembarking the aircraft. Thank you. We are joined by Wouter Boortes from the amazing book and new TV series Flights to Nowhere. One passenger who stayed behind, right? And, yes. You know, I take it this may have been more common an occurrence than it was now because of fear of flying. But at the same time, we have so much more modern technology with weather, but still people are still scared of flying. And so what do we do to try educate people?
Nothing is difficult for anybody to tell somebody else when they have this fear of flying. It's more dangerous to drive to the airport in your car than to get into a plane. It doesn't have an effect on anybody. It's not so much a fear of the aircraft or the flight, it's the idea of flight.
In March 1967, flight SAA 406, also called the Rietbok, took off from Johannesburg Jan Smuts Airport on a scheduled flight to Port Elizabeth. Little did everybody know that that would be the start of the first mystery in the aviation history of South Africa.
The one pilot, he confirmed that he saw the coastline on the left, and then he would have looked forward to see whether he would spot the runway lights.
This flight ended in disaster. Join me, Wouter Boortes, as I investigate the mystery surrounding this flight and many others in Flights to Nowhere.
Mango Airlines, one of South Africa's many low-cost carriers. Comair, South Africa's most profitable airline for 73 consecutive years. SA Express, South Africa's regional carrier. And South African Airways, South African's government, state-owned, corrupt airline. These airlines were all local favorites, but that wasn't long-lived.
A top story this morning, several planes, including some belonging to SAA and Comair, have been grounded. The Civil Aviation Authority found irregularities at maintenance and technical service provider SAA Technical.
I mean, the root cause of the decline of Mango came in its ever-changing leadership structure. The main leadership positions were constantly being shifted and adjusted. I mean, at the beginning of Mango, CEO Nico Bezuidenhout was recruited for the position. Many people thought he was the right person for the job, but some would disagree.
This is the storm ahead, the journey of the South African aviation industry.
In this series, the first airline we are going to cover is Mango, as it was one of the most well-known South African LCCs, and is one of the main competitors to airlines such as Kalula.com and FlySafair. Mango has a route network of 9 routes, placing it in close competition with other carriers. Mango also has great prices and a recent fleet of Boeing 737-800s, which made them an appealing airline to the public.
Mango, which is a subsidiary of state-owned South African Airways, was set up to facilitate more competition in the domestic aviation industry. It was also designed to give travellers more freedom of choice when booking. After all, there was the start of the South African low-cost carrier revolution. At the time when Mango was founded, 2 low-cost carriers were operating. Original LCCs Comair's Kalula.com and OneTime. OneTime sadly went into liquidation and later suspended operations in 2012.
Mango Airline, one of South Africa's low-cost carriers, a favourite of many, a family to some. Operating your bright orange aircraft and crew to 7 cities in Southern Africa, you soared above the clouds until you could soar no more. After lockdown struck, you were there to join friends and families, bring back much-needed precious cargo, and restore hope to our people. You flew when your sister airline could fly no more. You built a community of people around you, from the pilots, cabin crew, ground crew, and the passengers who made your airline an airline. You built a family of aviation enthusiasts who were there to see the highs and the lows. But now, the time has come, you are descent to your final destination. You've had your takeoffs. And you've had your landings.
South African Airways is once again taking off. Its low-cost cousin, Mango, is conspicuous in its absence. A new business rescue proposal for the orange carrier doesn't include the low-cost airline as part of SAA's future.
When you were criticized, you moved forward from it. When your journey was cut short, you advocated for yourself. You built a family flying to 7 cities in Southern Africa. You flew our passengers, our cargo, and you flew our nation. The end has arrived. You may be closing your doors, but your legacy will live on. For this is not the end. It's just the beginning.
On behalf of Mango, we'd like to thank you for making us your choice of airline today. It's been an absolute pleasure having you on board, and we look forward to seeing you on one of our flights in the future. Thank you. Have a good onward journey.
South African Airways, once one of the world's leading airlines. But it's been over 10 years since they've turned a profit. They've had everything from bad leadership to government scandals. It is now time to turn over a new leaf for the airline. This is a conversation about South African Airways version 2.0. Is it really too late to save SAA? This is the Aviator South Africa Chats.
Interesting thing to note is how there was no discussion about it on the European side. It was a very quick move. They just closed everything instantly. All airlines stopped operating except for KLM and Air France, which carried on. But then you still had to isolate within those different countries. After that, the chance of you getting into the UK, we don't know yet because it hasn't been 10 days since the ban has been put on South Africa. So it's possible that the UK could red list them at a later stage.
Hello and welcome to the Aviators South Africa Chats. Today we're talking all things Lyft. Lyft is one of South Africa's newest low-cost carriers, and they've entered the market in a rather competitive time, to say the least. We've been following them since their inception, before they even had a name, all the way to where they are now. Now today we're going to talk their business model, their comparison to their competitors, the SAA venture, and everything in between. This is the Aviators Chats.